I mean, it's really not as wild as people make it out to be. I'm not going to get into too much detail here because I don't, frankly, I don't know what's been said, and I think that's more of a Tony thing to speak on because it was his deal. But what I'll say is this: it was a comment coming off the ice, and guys are heated. We just lost in OT. Tony's a competitor. I freaking love the guy. He's one of my favorite teammates I've ever had. An incredible teammate, was extremely well loved by all his teammates in New York the entire time he was there. Didn't always get along with everybody at all times, but neither do I, and neither do a lot of, competitive guys that play with
Fire.
balls the way he plays with, and fire, and are just warriors the way he is, especially at his size and with how much skill he has. I mean, I just love his game. And so, they got into it, and it really didn't escalate very much. But it was just a series of unfortunate events, I think, for Tony. He was on a short leash, and he had a reputation, I think, coming in. And I think that it was handled poorly, and I think it's too bad because New York lost out on a hell of a player, and he missed a season almost, I feel like, because of stupidity and something that could have easily been handled in-house by the players, and it really wasn't a big deal at all. And so, yeah, I mean, that's all I'll say on it. It was nothing, and it could have easily been swept under the rug, I think. And I think it was more about what had happened in the past
Yeah.
and some other incidents, but Tony plays with fire, and that's part of what makes him a really good hockey player. And I'm excited to see how he does in Philly this year. I think he's going to have a great year.